Bait Tech, proud sponsors of the British Carp Cups. Hello and welcome to the Ladies British Carp Cup Final. We're here at the stunning Wetlands Carp Fishery based in Lincolnshire, a venue of just over 7 acres that holds 30 islands and carp to over 30 pounds. This weekend we've got England International Ladies and the three ladies from last year who podiumed, so this is going to be a great weekend of carp fishing. This weekend we have Carp England manager Miranda Brown bankside, so let's head down to Miranda and get this competition underway.
So we're here with Verlaine, last year's winner, in peg 7,
yep.
Second to last out the draw, not as what you expected.
No.
Not the peg you really wanted to be in?
No, draw's a draw at the end of the day, isn't it? And funny enough, Deb drew me again this year. So how canny is that? But yeah, I had a choice of peg 7 or peg 4. So definitely neither two that I wanted, but best of a bad choice and got to make the most of it.
So Emily, first out the draw, last year's runner-up, peg 10.
I fished this peg last year, came second, really pleased with that result. I thought that there would be fish here, as there were. I fished it last weekend. Had a walk round, new fish had been coming out from this swim. Obviously know the swim, so thought that would be beneficial. And just that went from there, basically.
Any particular features that have drawn you to it?
Yeah, there's a lot of islands on here, a lot of snags, lots of different options on this swim as well, so I felt that that was going to be good for me.
So we're down in Emily Blake's peg. And Josh, her partner, just lifting her first fish out of the water.
I was asleep when the rod went on. Yeah, we'll go back to bed again.
Just putting on the unhooking mat, ready to be weighed. Time, Mick Coxon there, head marshal, ready to do all the weights.
£10, 1 ounce.
£10, 1 ounce.
Must have been the nail varnish.
Yeah. Sporting a nice blue nail varnish there for the first fish.
Two fish on the bank already on the first day of the competition, so cracking start.
Really, really pleased. Did not expect to have the first fish in the competition at all, and then to get two within such close proximity of each other was absolutely brilliant. Really, really pleased. Hopefully I'll go on and do a bit more this year and try and beat my second place that I had last year.
So let's go into a little bit of your tactics here. So what colour bait are you using?
I'm using red baits on here. I fished this venue quite a lot last year for pleasure, not just for the competition, and found that red baits do work quite well. The fish seem to like them, so a 16mm boilie, don't go too big or too small, and that's also great for using the catty and getting them right out there.
And rigs, any particular rigs you're choosing to use this weekend?
I use a blowback rig. It's what I used last year on this venue, and it's a fail-safe for me, really simple rig. My hook link's usually on here around about 12 inch, maybe longer.
So just to sink the lead and leave the bait on top of the silt, which is quite a good tactic. So day 2, 7 in the morning. And we're in peg 1 with Amanda Curtis, who's caught a £20.14 mirror. Your PB, I believe?
Yes. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic.
So that puts you into second place currently?
Yes, one place above last year.
Great stuff. Tell us about the catch and what bait you're using.
I was caught on a hair rig on a bottom bait. Nice little cocoa pea, coconut and pineapple. So, and it put up a hell of a fight.
So another wasteling in the water, which can only mean one more thing. Another fish on the bank, and that's gone to Sam. Looking like, looking like a 13, 14 pound fish there. Nice little mirror. see what the weight's going to be.
£14.7.
A lovely start for Sam there, straight onto the leaderboard.
Half seven, day two, and we're in peg four, and another fish on the bank for Sam Hoskins, another England girl. So tell us about your catch.
I had a £14.7 first thing this morning. It's right in close in the margins. It's a little bit deeper down here. Drops off a little bit, so I put bait down there last night and it went off this morning.
So as we go into the second half of the competition, the halfway scores are as follows. In first place, Emily Blake with two fish for £23.9. In second place, Amanda Curtis with that stunning fish of £20.14. In third place, Samantha Hoskins with one fish for £14.7. It's been a fairly slow start here due to water levels and pressure on the lake, but I'm pretty sure these ladies are going to get involved in a few more fish. Bait Tech, proud sponsors of the British Carp Cups. Bait Tech, proud sponsors of the British Carp Cups.
Down here with Ellen Beedham, who's unfortunately lost a fish.
Totally gutted, absolutely gutted. The air was very blue.
It is early days and there's still two fish in it. Maybe one if we hook into the big one. So what's your thoughts on what you're going to do to change things?
I'm going to stick with pretty much, because I've had two bites, which is more than a lot of people have had, so I'm going to stick with the tactics I've got. I have tried zigs, I've had a go on the zig, I've had a go in a couple of different areas, but I've gone back to where I've had the takes because it's obviously working on them spots.
So back here in Emily Blake's peg, peg 10, who looks like she's landed a sizeable chunk. Josh there just preparing it to be weighed again.
Yeah, oh yeah, God, yeah. Yeah, 23.6 my PB was.
So Emily just mentioning her PB's currently 23.6. It looks like this could be beaten. Lovely looking mirror carp. Some stunning fish in this lake. Oh yeah, it's gone a fair distance round the scales. Let's get a closer look. Oh yeah.
26.15.
So there it is, Mick Coxon, 26.15. A new PB for Emily Blake, and what a time to get it in a final of a ladies' match.
I'm so happy.
Stunning looking fish. Your third fish, your third catch, a fish called Timsy at 26.15. Lovely mirror carp. How are you feeling?
Over the moon. New PB for me. My previous PB was 23.6, so absolutely ecstatic. Rod pretty much, alarms dropped back. Hit into it, and quite a battle really, to be honest, to get it in. It was quite difficult, but managed to get it over the net and yeah, over the moon.
Fishing the same spot down the same channel, I believe.
Yeah, exactly the same channel as yesterday. It's been a slow day today, I think, for everybody on the lake, but I sort of stuck to it with one rod. I've roved the other rod around the swim to see whether I could sort of nick one from somewhere else, but I've got both rods on there now.
So we're here with Dave, the head bailiff of Wetlands Carp Fishery. We're nearing the end of day two. We've had a few fish out. It's been a lot slower than last year. What's your view on it?
Pressure's been up and down. We've had some torrential rain, some storms. It always puts fish off. We are low on water. It's a different time of year from last year. Last year we've seen plenty of fish, plenty of action. It has been a struggle for the last couple of weeks. We've had some hot days, especially with the water being low. The heat's just getting straight to the fish. I think that's one of your main issues.
We've seen a lot of fish swimming about, but they're not really getting their heads down.
Yeah, there is a lot of fish. We've seen some big units out in the open water. It is an hard lake to start with. 9.5 acres, shallow, down to some 8 foot holes at the top. There's 37 different islands here and snags. It can be daunting to some anglers. But yeah, I think there's going to be some more fish out today through the night. There's plenty moving about. Some big units cruising about in the open waters. I think Emily might do it with a couple of more fish.
So the final morning of the Ladies' Cup final, and last year's winner just lands her first fish of the competition to put her on the leaderboard. Still all to play for on the last day. The lively fish we've got in there. Nice. Looks like a nice common carp.
Lots of colours on, isn't it?
Yeah, lovely.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready when you
So
want.
Elaine just moving the fish from the retainer into the weigh sling to be weighed. And that's so that the fish are all evenly weighed in the same sling. So Mick to call it.
17 pounds dead.
Beautiful common carp. Stunning colours. Well done, Elaine.
You can smile, Wayne.
And they've all come out this morning, can you believe?
Really?
Yeah, there were no commons till these.
Last morning, you've managed to winkle one out at 7 o'clock this morning to put you into fourth. How are you feeling?
Bit nervous. I just want to try and get that last podium place now in third, so just one fish in it. I'm just chucking everything at it that I can now, just to get one out.
So third place is on £20.15, that's Amanda Curtis. You're in fourth. What other tactics are you trying?
I've pulled back off of mid-water where I had my fish from earlier this morning, thinking that they're now going to come out the deeper water and into these shallows. Sun's coming out, it's going to warm up quite quickly, I think. I've seen a few already basking in the sun and coming around in the bay, so I'm just going to try that. Put a small little bait in. I've actually put a little bit of hemp in, which I haven't used all weekend because of the bream. So hopefully, fingers crossed, I can just nick that one more fish.
So Debbie and Peg 6 had one through the night. Another one in the sling. This could potentially put Debbie up into second place.
Ian, would you just like to check this for me?
So the runner just going over to check the zero in of the scales. All girls are allowed a runner. Just to help them with the weighing of the fish on the bank.
It's the second fish, it's important. Thanks above and under.
Just gently moving the fish from the retainer into the sling.
Yeah. £9.07.
So £9.07, that puts her into second place. We're in peg 6 with Debbie. 4 hours to go, the last day of the competition. Moved into second place. Tell us about your catches.
I had a 19.7, I think it was. No, 19.14 this morning, about 4:30. Nice little mirror.
And then, I don't know, about half six, had a 9-7 common. So, yeah, it was good. It was a bit frantic, I have to say, because I hadn't long got the rod out and, you know, recast from the first fish. And next thing I know, it was going off again. So
second place, nerves starting to jangle?
Yeah, definitely. I feel more confident now than I did, but obviously it's, you know, still anyone's match.
The fish seem to have moved down this end of the lake as well. So.
Yeah, I mean, they've been all over the surface all weekend, but, you know, just trying to get them to get their heads down has been a bit of a nightmare. But, yeah, they're definitely here, and hopefully we can keep them here and catch a few more.
So have you changed any tactics to trap these two?
We've changed, or certainly I've changed, a couple of bait tactics that I was using. You know, we've tried everything, pop-ups, bottom baits, snowmen, high-vis, you name it, just trying to get a fish. And what I've done last night has worked, because I've had two fish on it. So yeah.
Typical match tactics, yeah, changing about till you catch them.
Definitely. If it's not working, you've got to change it. So yeah, and be nice to see a few of the other England girls bagging a few and getting on the podium.
So only a couple of hours left, two fish ahead. We're on 62 pound here. You've had no fish this morning, but they're beginning to catch down the other end of the lake now. So how does that feel?
I had a fish at 8 o'clock last night. A change of tactics really paid off. Saw a couple of fish cruising around in the bay, so put a rod on it, and within about 40 minutes it ripped off with an 11 pound mirror. So I mean, that definitely helped yesterday. Had a couple of takes this morning. It's a difficult venue to fish. It's very snaggy, really weird takes, a lot of drop backs. It's just the nature of the venue really. But I'll just keep on pushing on, and hopefully might get first place.
There's been a tough time for them this weekend because the weather hasn't helped. Fish have been quite high in the water. So what do you think you would do in this position?
To be fair, there's nothing really that they haven't tried. Speaking to all of them, they've tried every single method that I would probably try. Pop-ups, wafters, zigs, anything that you think that will bring that. If they're mid-water, they're moving, they're changing, they're recasting, they're baiting up. I know that the girls, the carp girls, had a fish, I think, late last night in regards to they put a lot of bait on the spot and that brought the fish onto them. And I think it just got a bit quieter, if I'm honest. That's the indication they're giving. So I think it's just a tough water. I wouldn't try anything else they haven't tried. They've done everything they possibly can. So it's just tough, I think.
And there's a lot happening in the ladies' carp scene at the moment. Obviously, Carp Team England, we've got off the ground. We've got the UK ladies running alongside. So we're now moving towards helping our women in sport, which you're linked to as well, and doing a lot with that. What's happening in your side of things?
Yeah, no, the UK ladies carp team is obviously linked in some way, because that's where some of the England players, England sort of team came from. Yeah, we've got things going on. We've got some social matches coming up. So if anyone's interested, either, you know, from a carp perspective or even from a women perspective, that's what we're trying to do, is get people out there, get people on the bank, linked obviously highly with the Angling Trust. We're trying to get people into fishing. Just get them, you know, I've been to Radley lately with linked to women with sport and with the carp team, showing people how to carp fish. It was quite surprising how many people didn't know anything about carp fishing. You know, they never seen a bivvy before, which was great to raise the awareness, and obviously for women in sport too. So yeah, I've been linked to the women in sport group, you know, keeping in touch with them, letting me know what's going on.
So Paula, it's been a tough weekend for you, quite quiet down this end of the lake until now, but fish are obviously showing in your peg. What are you doing to catch them?
Yeah, it's been a pretty tough weekend for me, just been plugging away at it. Yep, they've definitely appeared in my swim this morning. In fact, I think they've been in my swim all weekend really. Just had a lot of trouble getting them to go down and feed on my spot. So this morning I've changed onto a lighter pop-up. That's been my tap this morning, and I'm just hoping to pinch one before the horn blows. 1 hour left.
All to play for.
All to play for, yeah. I mean, one fish and that could put me in a position. So not giving up yet. Still watching, still moving them around. And my plan is just to plant it on their head whenever I see them show.
Have you enjoyed the weekend?
I've had a great weekend. It's my first time here at the Ladies British Carp Cups, and I've learnt a lot. Haven't caught anything, but yeah, I'll be back next year, and hopefully things that I've learnt this weekend will stand me in better stead for next year.
Yes, quite a tough field of ladies out there. You've got five England internationals, last year's winner, last year's first, second and third podium positions of fishing this weekend.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's been a tough field, but you've enjoyed it.
I've enjoyed it thoroughly, yeah.
Did you have any fun? believe it.
I can't believe it, mate. I can't believe it. You right?
I dream about this. I dream about these things happening to me.
How are you feeling?
Effort equals reward, mate.
Oh, doesn't it,
Jess? That's how I feel.
Well done. Brilliant effort. Emily, the small says it all, second last year and champion this year. How are you feeling?
Absolutely fantastic. Can't believe it. You know, dream of moments like this, never thinking that it'll happen to me, but put the effort in and it's paid off.
So you've only been fishing 18 months as well, and to be champion, you must be absolutely stoked with yourself.
Fantastic, especially having a spinal operation as well late last year. Really eager to get back out on the bank. Brilliant.
So there we have it. What an awesome weekend's fishing we've had here at the Wetlands Carp Fishery. And our final scores are as stands. Emily Blake, our new Ladies British Carp Cup champion, with 4 fish for £62.7. In second place, Debbie Taylor. In peg 6, she had 2 fish in the end. Quick succession on the last morning, taking her into that podium position of £29.5. Once again, for the second year running, Amanda Curtis in third place with 1 fish and a new PB of £20.14. Don't forget, ladies, if you are into your carp fishing and you want to join in, this is open to anybody and everybody as long as you are female. Get yourself registered, get down to the Wetlands and get yourselves involved.
Oh, Dad.
Bait Tech, proud sponsors of the British Carp Cups.